Assalamu alaikum dear friends, today I am here to explain and telling the its paper design chapter 23 important MCQs in 2020. That MCQs are very very important for you. That MCQs each is step in each is MCQs is very very important for you. Not skip and not miss any step. And I will tell the reasons and solutions here why the MCQs are correct. So must watch this lecture completed till end if you want to get more concept. So if you want to gain other chapter MCQs, remaining chapter MCQs from starting to ending, then must watch description below the video, because below the lecture in description I have sent other chapter MCQs. So must watch that link here. Thanks. Now let's start the video. Here the MCQs is first that experimental design. Very simple MCQ. Everyone know that experimental design means a plan, not design. Plan, which is the plan used to collect the data in any other problem. When we use that plan, that plan is called as experimental design, which is used in calculation. So must remember that experimental design means plan. Now moving the second MCQs, very simple, very easy. The purpose of randomization is to dash bytes and other sources of external. Very simple. The purpose of randomization is to remove bytes. That target is here, remove error and other sources of extraneous variation. So must remember that the purpose of randomization. So must clear have the process. The purpose of randomization is to remove bias and other sources of extraneous variation. I hope that you are clearly concepting that. Now maybe the third MCQ. Third MCQ is very easy. I told you that a term referring to the amount of balancing, in which we have balancing, blocking and grouping. And the experimental, you know, just like we can see that WhatsApp groups. Where WhatsApp group have, we have balancing, we have members, blocking and grouping. Just like WhatsApp, we have control and ownership, so that the correct answer will be local control. So must was, I hope that you have clearly concepting that a term referring to the amount of balancing, blocking and grouping of experiment is called as local control, because we have a ownership, we have a control in balancing, grouping and blocking. So I hope that you are clear concepting that what is local control. You can use the definition here, that is what is local control. Now moving that four MCQs is very important, and very important. We are telling you that you have clear concept in calculation, in MCQs, in any other problems. A complete randomized design, which is CR design, is also called two-way, one-way. Very simple. A randomized design also called as one-way ANOVA. So must remember that just like one-way ANOVA, we use method in ANOVA. Every step we can use in completely randomized design. So must have clear concept in that. One-way ANOVA is also called completely randomized design, and completely randomized is also called one-way ANOVA, because they have same methods, same calculations. I hope that you are clear concepting that. Now moving that, five MCQs is that a randomized complete block design, very simple, is also called as two-way ANOVA. So must remember that that's a key points. Completely randomized design is a one-way ANOVA, and randomized complete block design is a two-way ANOVA. And we know that two-way ANOVA calculation methods are same here in randomized complete, but there is a difference here. It has blocks. It has block one, block two, block three. But there is a difference that we have given question block three and up to so on. So that's in using randomized complete blocks, and they have a blocks. But method is same, just like a two-way ANOVA. I hope that you have clear concept in that. Now moving that Latin square design. Very simple. Now moving that Latin square design. Lateral scale design is very very important for you. Lateral scale design is also called as very very simple. It's also called as three-way ANOVA. So must remember that lateral scale design is a three-way ANOVA. Is a three-way ANOVA. In that we have number of rows, number of columns, and number of treatments are on equal to each other in just three-way ANOVA. There's a specialty here. This is called as three-way ANOVA. That's called as lateral scale design. So much, much clear. I hope that you have clear concept in that six MCQs. What is lateral scale? Lateral scale is a three-way ANOVA. Now, in lateral scale design, number of rows, I have told you clear that, number of columns and number of treatments are all equal to each other. Because they are equal to each other, the effect answer will be equal. So I hope that you have clear concept in that. In lateral scale design, number of rows, number of columns, number of treatments are equal to each other. So now moving that, in lateral scale design, V2, very very important, very very, in degree of freedom, F alpha V1 V2. Now I'm telling you key points and secrets, because here in that's important for you. V1. Here V1 is equal to, in lateral scale design, in lateral scale design, three-way ANOVA, V1 is equal to R minus 1. So must remember that in lateral scale design, V1 degree of freedom first is equal to R minus 1. R is the number of rows minus 1. Yeah? And next V2. Must remember that V2 is a degree of freedom, that's that error degree of freedom. V2 is the error degree of freedom. Must remember that, I am telling you key point and secret, that V2 is here is a error degree of freedom. That's that error degree of freedom. That formula is very very simple. V2 is equal to RC minus 1. RC minus 1, where n is equal to RC. Must remember that small n is equal to number of rows, but like on the column, we can say that, I hope that you clear that C is equal to K. We can say that small n is equal to RK as a same. Now, V2 is equal to RC minus 1 minus bracket R minus 1 plus C minus 1 plus K minus 1. So that's the degree of freedom, second degree of freedom in lateral scale. V1 is equal to R minus 1. Must remember that V2 is an error degree of freedom. V2 is equal to RC minus 1. We can use here N minus 1, because N is equal to RC, same as minus R minus 1 plus C minus 1 plus K minus. I hope that you have clear concept in one way, two way, lateral scale designs. Now discussing that. Last MCQ, in lateral scale design, V2 is an error degree of freedom. So the correct answer is error degree of freedom. Now moving to the 9 MCQ, very very important. In completely randomized design, standard alpha estimate very very easy. Standard alpha estimate is equal to square root of error mean square, which is S square E, now divided by number of observations in treatment mean. Number of observation treatment mean, put here number of observation, and put here mean scale error divided as standard error. I hope that you have clear concepts in that. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, then kindly must subscribe to my YouTube channel and must press bell icon button for getting notification of my new lecture. Goodbye.